cities.
The claim I find hardest to understand is this claim that Libya's youth are being given hallucinatory pills and then brainwashed to attack. Again, Gaddafi said it was Americans doing this first. Now he says it's bin Laden. What drugs are being used specifically? What hallucinatory pills?
Actually, the leader did not specifically accuse the United States of America. He really said that Al-Qaeda are very highly trained individuals who now look more secular than the dwellers of the caves in Afghanistan. They wear trainers and jeans.
I'm asking you, what pills? What hallucinatory pills?
Young people to join them against. We did indeed capture young people using those pills to.
What pills? No, I'm asking. I mean, are you talking about methamphetamine? Are you talking about ecstasy? Are you talking about LSD? Are you talking? What are you talking about?
I'm not an expert. We are really now dealing with the matter from all sides. Let me just.
Wait, sir. Let me just go. I got to ask this because you are basing your entire argument. Your leader is basing the entire. His entire explanation, he says this every time, on these hallucinatory pills. It seems to defy logic. You're saying that a small band of terrorists have been able to manufacture, import, distribute large quantities, huge quantities of hallucinatory pills across vast areas, hundreds of miles apart, to various cities, and then been able to continually drug tens of thousands of Libyan young people so that they will fight? Does that make any sense to you at all?
No, this is not the story. Anderson, this is not the story we are putting forward. This is one element of the story.
But that's the story you mentioned that Gaddafi and his son mention every time they talk.
The situation here. No, Anderson, you have to let me... Anderson, you have to let me make my point.
I'm asking you what pills. This is a huge part of your explanation, but go ahead.
No, I'm saying to you, And my answer to you is that this is one element of the story. The main core of the story is what your state Secretary of State, Mrs. Hillary Clinton, said only a few hours ago, that Al-Qaeda is trying and hoping to send Libya into chaos and disorder so they could have a Mediterranean Somalia only half an hour away from Europe in a vast, vast region of Libya. Libya is 1.7 million square kilometer. If Al-Qaeda gets hold of the chaos here, then this is extremely dangerous to Europe and to the States.
I don't think anyone's arguing that point.
We have been cooperating very wonderfully with the United States. We have been at the forefront of fighting against terrorism. Terrorism now is winning inside.
You've been at the forefront against terrorism?
To give us help.
Did you just say your regime has been at the forefront
in the
of
last
fighting
few years,
against terrorism?
We have abandoned, yes, yes, and I'll give you the examples, the powerful examples. We have abandoned publicly and internationally our weapons of mass destruction project, which has been presented as a good example to the North Koreans and the Iranians to follow. We have cooperated fully against Al-Qaeda activities in Libya and North Africa. Libya is the only country free of Al-Qaeda and the region. If Al-Qaeda gets hold of this country, then they will link themselves to Egypt.
Well, you claim it's not free. You claim there are thousands of Al-Qaeda-related affiliates all throughout your country. But let me ask you, Saif Gaddafi had said that on February 20th, he would provide evidence of this massive drugging conspiracy. He said there are documents and he would provide evidence that it would be forthcoming shortly. I've yet to see anything on these magic hallucinatory pills. That again, you're basing a lot of your explanation on, and yet no one's provided any evidence.
I would like to get away from any sensationalist reporting. Anderson...
Sir, I'm responding to what your leaders have said. Is that not sensationalist?
Small element.
What it is ludicrous, and that's why you can't come up with an explanation for it.
But if you take the... But if you take the timeshare the leader gave to these pills, it's very small. It's one element that we discovered with young people in the city of Tripoli and other cities. And we are ourselves wondering about these pills. But the story is much, much bigger. What we think, Anderson, is that the international community's reaction towards what's happening in Libya has been not very honest and transparent. The Security Council, for example, Anderson, based its agreement against Libya on media reports, without Anderson, I mean, you have to look at this very carefully. Any fact-finding mission without visiting Libya, without allowing Libya to defend itself in the UN, and the guy who's supposed to be the lawyer of Libya, the representative of Libya, was going against his own country.
Right, they,
so
they've defected.
Left without
they've left,
any representation,
left your side.
No fact-finding mission.
Sir, I the reason I bring up the hallucinatory pills is because I think internationally,
our new guy.
Right. The reason I bring up the hallucinatory pills is because I think internationally, when people hear that, and again, we hear it every time your leader speaks and every time his son speaks, I think people think that's ludicrous, and they think if he's lying about that and making stuff up about that, then why should we believe other stuff he's